Okay. Hi, I'm Maeve. Get a block if you have one. And we're going to sit. You could actually use two blocks if you wanted. I will show you both versions. We're going to start seated. This doesn't necessarily, even with blocks, this doesn't necessarily work for everyone. But you can stack two blocks if you have two blocks. Bring your knees around and then perch your booty on the top. You might not need to. For me, one is enough. Or if you have the one and you put it up one height, that might be enough as well. So you kind of have to play with it and figure out where you want to be. You can also, if you're comfortable like this without a block, grand, wonderful, have at it. Palms up, backs of the hands on your thighs. Draw your chest up. Just taking a moment here. Hasta mudra, this open palm. It's like a welcoming, inviting hand position for receiving, to receive. And right at this moment, just receive your breath. It's Friday the 13th. I didn't realize that until I saw an email in my inbox talking about Friday the 13th and how it's become this sort of superstitious, unlucky day and how that came to be. I thought it was very interesting, and I'm not going to bore you with that. You can look it up if you want. And the source of the email was saying, like, it's a good day to tap into your intuition. And then I didn't get further into the article, so I can't give you more than that. But I thought it was a very interesting sort of take on this day that we might deem as unlucky to instead use it as an opportunity to be a little more intuitive. And this practice is very much, what I ask of you is very much intuitive. To do things that feel good, to do things that challenge you physically, mentally, sometimes emotionally. But to trust your intuition, when to back off, when to go deeper. So in this first moment, just opening yourself up to receive. Bring your hands together, lace your fingers, turn your palms forward, and then press forward. Kind of spread the shoulder blades, really nice. And then maybe this starts to come up a little higher. And maybe it comes up all the way, but it might not too. Yeah. And then your elbows might not be totally straight here, that's fine. Energetically kind of squeeze those upper arms in a little bit. Whether that means your arms straighten or not. And then with the arms reaching up, notice the position of your spine. So my back is pretty bendy. Not like it used to be, but still quite bendy. So for me, it takes a little bit of effort to remind myself, so effort mentally, effort physically, to remind myself not to just collapse into my back, but instead draw the front ribs to the back body a little bit, to use my back ribs to send the arms a little longer. And when I do that, I get a completely different sensation in my shoulders than when I don't do that. It's completely different. One more breath here. Release the arms. Rise up onto your knees. Take your right leg out to the right. Okay. If you need to turn on your mat or anything, go for it. I'm just going to move my block out of the side, out to the side. And then bring your left hand down. And then right arm just reaches up and over. Press like crazy into that left knee, left foot, left hand to get a nice big arcing position in your body. Breath in, and then rise up and over to the other side. And just gentle contact here. A block is great here if, like, your leg feels like it's not in the right place for your hand. If you want to just mix it up, I don't know. Blocks are great just to have around, just in case something doesn't feel right. A come around. Bring your hands to the top of your mat. So if you kind of shifted yourself, shift yourself back. Tuck the right toes and then sweep this left leg up and back. Good. Keep your hips neutral as best you can. Breath in. Exhale. Hover the left foot off the floor. Bring it back down. Inhale, bring it down. It was never down. Inhale, take it up and back. Exhale, hover the foot. Inhale. And exhale. Two more times. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And then exhale. Bring your knee forward. Place your left foot forward. Bring your right knee down. And then Anjaneyasana, rising up. Press into the back foot, whether the toes are pointed or tucked, doesn't matter to me, but push into that back foot. Engage the right hip here. Gently lift the front hip points. Lace your hands like we did when we were kneeling. Push the hands forward and then sweep them up. Outer, upper arms gently in, hands higher. Back body supporting you. Now this time, with this arm position, if it feels okay, we're gonna take a little back bend here. And that doesn't mean that I'm just collapsing. Quite the opposite. Lifting up to go back. Inhale, rise up. And then straighten the front leg. You can shift your hips back as much as you want. So if you wanna make contact, right hip to right heel, if that's okay on your knee, go for it. If that's not good, keep some space there. Blocks are spectacular here. Inhale, rise up. Good. Walk your hands around. Kind of coming back to where we started. This leg out to the side. Good. We're gonna have left leg out to the side. So second side. We had right leg, now left leg. Good. Beautiful. Right hand down, up and over. Big side bend. Inhale, rise up, and then over to the other side. So for this next little bit, we'll be facing the back of your mat. It's not tragic. And you've already done it, so it's gonna be easy breezy. But if for any reason that just throws you off your game, you're gonna flip yourself around if you need to. Come back up. Bring your hands around. Tuck your left toes, right leg to the sky. Do your best to keep your hips neutral. Breath in. And then exhale, lower your foot toward the ground without touching. Inhale with control, lift up. And exhale, whoops, release your foot down. Again, inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. I'm hoping you feel, one more time, a little bit of that glute work in that right leg to hold the leg up, knee down the center, and then right foot between your hands, left knee down. Lace your hands, push your hands away, lift up, Anjaneyasana, maybe finding a little back bend here. Use your back foot a lot. One more inhale. Release the hands, Ardha Hanumanasana. If you want to instead sink the hips back, go for it. Yes, really, really nice. Beautiful. We've been doing a lot of shoulder work recently, and I've been doing my best to kind of pick a theme and kind of stick to it for a period of time so that it kind of really gets in your body and gets in your movement patterns. So there'll be more shoulder work today. Yay, right? In the corners of my mind. Good. Rebend that front leg. Come back around. This time, just bring your knees back in, right where we started. Really good. And then sink down. Good. Take the arms out. We're just going to do a little bit of internal and external rotation in the shoulder girdle. Yeah, sit comfortably. However, we won't be here for long, but however it makes you feel good, sit comfortably. So back onto my train of thought that I so quickly lost. I'm doing my best to stay on like a theme for a chunk of time, like a month or so, so that we integrate it into everything we do and how the shoulder girdle relates to back bends and balance poses and wraps and just general shoulder stuff. So without telling you what we're going to work on today, just know that whatever work you've done, if you've been in my class this week or last week that we did for shoulders, it'll be integrated here. So we just build on it. And in reality, that's what the practice is we're constantly building on something that we've learned in a previous class. So even if, not just my classes, even if the focus isn't on a specific thing, we take that with us into each practice rather than just like, oh, I did that, I don't need to do it anymore. Rise up. Good. All right, come on to hands and knees. Right fingers are going to point forward, left fingers are going to point back. If this doesn't feel good, you simply just don't do it. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Inhale and exhale. A few more rounds. And then switching the hands. Left fingers forward, right fingers back. If it doesn't work, don't do it. That hand around, elbows come down, blocks here are great, and then dropping the heart through, pressing the elbows down as you drop through, maybe pulling the hands back behind the head. And then coming forward, forearm plank, palm the ground. If you want, you can bring your hands together, but if you can, in this forearm plank, see if you can keep your arms in parallel. Push the floor away with your feet, with your hands, your forearms, your elbows. Scoop the belly up. Take the gaze past your fingers. Slowly hips lower down. Sphinx. Good. Start to pull the thumbs toward each other. Maybe as you palm the floor more, the elbows might float up. Oh, hi, mister. He brought me a toy. You're such a good hunter. Slide your right hand back a little bit. Push down into that hand. Slide your left hand back a little bit. Come into cobra. And downward facing dog. Exhale. You want this? Go get it. Inhale, lift your heels. Bend your knees, look at your hands, bring your feet to your hands. Halfway with your breath in, and fold with your breath out. Inhale, all the way up. And then exhale, hands to your heart. I was with you the whole time. Inhale, reach up. Little pause here, lace the fingers, push the palms away. Outer upper arms press in. Good. Let your shoulders travel up. You don't need to depress your shoulders down. Engage your glutes. Pull up on your thighs. Feel your center working here. So instead of being here, here. Side bend over to the right. Yeah. Rise up, side bend to the left. Yeah, yes. Inhale, rise up, and exhale, forward fold. Inhale, come halfway. step back plank. Breath in and plank. Lower to your belly. Slide your forearms forward. Sphinx. And then tuck your toes and forearm plank. Float your right leg up. Right foot down. Float your left leg up. Left foot down. Sphinx again. Start to pull the thumbs in toward each other. Maybe the forearms start to lift and then slide. So really press into your left hand. Slide your right hand back. Press into your left hand. Slide your right hand back. Cobra. Yes. Downward facing dog. Exhale. So good. Inhale, lift your heels. Stay with me, please. Bend your knees a lot. Stretch your butt back. So you're spring loading your legs. Look at your thumbs and then walk, step, or jump to your feet to hands using this. Inhale, halfway. Bow down, exhale. Inhale, rise. And hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, reach up. Beautiful. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway. Plank, exhale. Inhale, plank. Draw your thumbs toward each other. Exhale, chaturanga dandasana or the floor. Inhale, up dog, cobra, sphinx, shalabhasana, you pick. Down dog, exhale. Inhale, high to your toes. Bend your knees, send your butt back. Look at your hands, feet to hands. Inhale, halfway. Fold, exhale. Inhale, rise. Hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bow. Inhale, halfway. Chaturanga or plank lowering. Inhale, rise. Down dog, exhale. Inhale, heels high. Exhale, stretch back, feet to hands. Halfway inhale. Bow, exhale. Rise, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Rise up, inhale. Exhale, bow. Inhale, halfway. Right foot steps back, exhale. Anjaneyasana, place that right knee down gently. Rise up, little back bend. And then shift your hips back, half splits. Or maybe go back even further. Inhale, rise up. Kind of pivot around. Gate pose. Take that left hand to your left leg. Beautiful. Good. Now I promise, it's all going to be easy breezy. Bring your hands to the back of your mat. Tuck your left toes. Three-legged dog. Sweep that right leg up and back. Just listen. I promise you're going to be fine. I promise you're going to be fine. Lift your left heel. Bend your left knee. Send your hips back. Now on the one leg, the same way we jump forward that we did for our step forward from when we were doing Surya Namaskar A, you're using this left leg in the same way. You're gonna pop this left foot to your hands. Lengthen the spine halfway, inhale, and then melt standing splits. You're at the back of the mat, no big deal. No big deal. You're gonna start to look back to the top of your mat. You're gonna bend your left knee. You're gonna reach that right foot way, way, way back to the top of your mat. You're gonna come up around Skandasana in your right hip. So you've traveled back home. Okay, if you have a block, I'm gonna suggest you have it handy. You're gonna put it in front of you. So it's gonna be to the left side of the top of your mat. You're gonna pivot around, left hand comes to the block, square off your right leg. I gotta back up just a smidge because I'm hitting furniture here. And then you're gonna open up revolved half moon. Yes, so right arm reaches up, left leg stretches back, left hand down. Fantastic. Your inhale draws you up to stand, reach up to the sky, bring your feet in parallel, and then bow forward, exhale. Inhale, halfway. Step your left foot back, Anjaneyasana, left knee gently down, rise up, little back bend here, and then straighten the front leg, shift your hips back. Good. Come back up. You're gonna pivot your left foot, right leg stretches toward the top of your mat, and then right hand to right leg, little lift up and over. Again, we're bringing hands to the back of the mat. Tuck the right toes, left leg to the sky. Take a few breaths here. Enjoy a few breaths, I should say. There's no need to take them, they're yours. Enjoy them. And then listen, lift your right heel high. Bend your right knee, stretch your hips back, look at your hands, and then bring your right foot to your hands. Keep your left leg lifted. Lengthen, inhale. And bow back down, exhale, standing splits. Start to take your gaze to the top of your mat. Start to bend your standing leg. Stretch your left foot way back. And then Skandasana into this left hip. Top of your mat. Beautiful. Well done. Very nice. In the beginning of class, we were in down dog, three-legged dog, and we lowered the leg and we lifted the leg. And my goal was to try to get you to feel how your center, your abs and your glute create that movement. When we transition here into revolved half moon, we need that energy. Bring your right hand around, square off your left toes, float the right leg up. So belly strong. Glutes working here, turn to the left, and left arm up. Rise up to stand, bring the feet in parallel. Hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway. Right foot steps back, exhale. Crescent pose, inhale. Same energy as Anjaneyasana. Exhale, release your hands down. Straighten this front leg. Little pause here. Enjoy some breaths. Rebend the left knee. Plant your hands. Left leg sweeps back. Open up your hip if it feels good. Hips, really, you're opening both. Come back to center. Get super high in the right toes. Bend your right knee, look at your hands, and then bring your right foot to the top of your mat. Inhale, length. Melt with your exhale. Standing splits. This time, we're gonna spot the back of the mat and Skandasana to the back of your mat into your left hip. push from the left foot, pull from the right foot. Half moon. We've already got the twisting one over with. This is going to feel like a piece of cake. Maybe bend the top leg, find your foot. And then if you like, kick it away. Keep the belly strong. Engage the left glutes. Allow this left shoulder to get a nice opener here if you have that foot. Good. Start to come around. Left knee lifts up. Rise up. Cross. Maybe wrap. Left arm under, right arm on top. Eagle. Unravel, inhale, rise up, reach up, little back bend if it feels good. Bow forward, exhale. Inhale, halfway. Left foot steps back. Crescent pose, inhale. Exhale, hands down. Blocks if you need them. Straighten both legs. Enjoy a few breaths here. Use your hands not just to hold your balance, but to give your trunk stability, to feed into the shoulder girdle, to feed into the spine. Palm the floor, sweep the right leg back. Come high, 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 high into those left toes. Bend the left knee. Oh, I lied. Open up your hips. I forgot we did that. Sorry. This is going to help for the half moon. Chapasana version. Okay, good. Now, stretch the leg back. Bend your left knee. Look at your hands. The same way you would spring forward if you were coming from the back of your mat in down dog, the top of your mat and sun salutes, just hop forward. Good. And then, I think I screwed all this up, but it's okay. We're gonna fix it, I promise. Come into half moon here. I forgot to do our skandhasana. Don't worry, I'm gonna get it in, I promise you. Good. Good. Beautiful. I know why, because this is supposed to be standing splits. That's why. Go to the back of your mat. Skandhasana, into that right hip. It's all gonna work out. We are gonna keep this transition the same into half moon like we did on the first side, just because we've got this left hip in external rotation. We're digging the heel down, we're working this hamstring. It's kind of prepping us for this beautiful half moon. Come forward, bring the hand down, and lift up. And then if you want, because we already had a little taste of half moon on this side because I screwed up, you can bend the top leg, find your foot. So watch your shoulder here. Let the shoulder roll open, press away. Mm-hmm. Yes. Really nice. Start to bring that knee around. And then rise up. And cross or wrap. Right arm under, left arm on top. Rise up, reach up. Hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bow. Halfway, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Rise, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Right leg stretches back, hips stay neutral. Right knee draws into your center, round your upper back. Push the ground away, try to lift the shin as high as you can. Drop the shin toward the floor, and then pull it back up. Drop the shin toward the floor, pull it back up. One more time, drop down, and then draw up. Step the right foot forward. Back heel roots, reverse warrior, come up and back. Straighten the front leg. Tip over. Triangle. Bend your right knee, your front knee. You might need a few steps before this, so if you need to bring your foot back first, that's fine. If you can, put your right hand down. You're gonna bring the right knee to your right tricep, pick up the right foot. And then left forearm is gonna come down. Right forearm comes down. Forearm plank. Now listen, root that left forearm. Slide your right hand back quite a bit until you're in chaturanga on the right arm. Does anybody really know where they go when they die? Bring the forearm forward, lower the hips. Sphinx, inhale, maybe lift the elbows. Maybe start to slide the hands back. Woo! Cobra, yeah, down dog, exhale. Beautiful. Very, very nice. Stay in your breath. Well done. Inhale, left leg stretches back. Exhale, draw your knee down the center, round the upper back. Back leg super strong. I neglected to say that on the other side, but really work that back leg. Lower the shin toward the floor. Draw it back up. Round the back, push away. Do it again. Drop down. Pick it up. And one more time. And then step this left foot forward. Right heel roots. Reverse warrior, come up and back. So good. It happens in a minute, happens in a minute. It happens in a minute, happens in a minute. It happens in a minute, happens in a minute. Notice the energy of the left arm. Make it stronger. Notice the energy of this right arm, this right shoulder. Make it stronger. Inhale, straighten that front leg. Exhale, simply tip over. Triangle. Mm-hmm. Wherever your hand wants to fall. Yes. And then start to bend your front leg, your left leg. get your hand to the floor as best you can, and then pull that right, left foot back, left knee to your left elbow. Whoo! Open up. Right forearm down. Left forearm down. Forearm plank. Stabilize. And then left hand comes quite a bit back so that you've got chaturanga in the left arm. Forearm plank in the right. Left forearm comes back around. Hips come down. Sphinx, maybe start to lift the forearms. Maybe start to pull those hands back. Cobra. And down dog. Beautiful. Spectacular. If you need a child's pose here, you've got a moment. You got a moment. Well done. Lift your heels high, inhale. Bend your knees deeply, look at your hands. Stretch your hips back, bring your feet to your hands. Halfway up, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. And draw your hands to your heart, exhale. Beautiful. Let's take a little pause, turn your palms up. So we started kneeling with our palms up, Hasta Mudra, this inviting, welcoming, reception, receiving space. We're gonna add a little energy to our hands here. So just barely curling like the first knuckle of all your fingers inward a little bit. So like a little mini claw, like you're just barely pulling in. Like if you have a cat and they're about to knead, it's like that. You saw the claws are about to come out. That's what I want, just that little bit there. Feel the energy that that gives your hands when you do that. And it's pretty subtle, it's not like you're aggressively drawing in. It's just a subtle energy, it wakes up the hands a bit. And we're gonna apply this to the ground. And it's not gonna look quite as drastic on the ground because you've got ground pressure, you've got hand pressure into the ground. So just like when I say like draw your legs toward each other, it's subtle because you're rooted. You're gonna be rooted, but we're gonna engage this just a little bit. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bow forward. Come up halfway with your inhale. Right foot steps back with your exhale. Crescent pose, inhale. And then exhale, hands down. Blocks or floor, straighten the front leg. Maybe lift your toes up this time. If you took the toes up, it's not just the toes, it's the whole foot minus the heel. I always say toes, and it's really not just the toes. Bring the foot back down, plant your hands, sweep the left leg up and back. Now get that sense of the fingertips just gently drawing in. Lift high into the right toes. Bend the right knee. Look at your hands. Push off the right leg, hop your right foot forward. Keep your left leg lifted. Inhale, lengthen, and standing splits here. Keep the hands, if you need to use blocks, use blocks. If you need to bend your right leg, your standing leg, to get your hands to the ground, do that. So if you need to bend your standing leg, get your hands down, create that energy in the hands, send that energy up into the shoulders. If you want, lift your right heel, bend your right knee even more, and then the same energy it took from the back of the mat to come here, you use here to lift up. It's the exact same thing. Right foot back down. Spot the back of your mat. Skandhasana. Take it back. Awesome. Really nice. Beautiful. Come forward. Come into side angle, just for a couple breaths. We haven't been here. Any shape of it. And then you're gonna plant this right hand. You're gonna pick up this right foot. Knees to your tricep. Left forearm comes around. Right hand's gonna slide back. Chaturanga in that right arm. Right leg is lifted. If you can. Good. Right forearm comes back around. Right leg is still lifted if it's okay. And then release down, Sphinx. Whew. Maybe up to Cobra. Down dog. Exhale. Smooth out your breath. Right leg stretches back. Left heel lifts. Bend your left knee a lot. Look at your hands. Hop your left foot to the top of your mat. And half moon. Open up. Maybe Chapasana. Bring that right knee around. Rise up. Coming into eagle, crossing or wrapping. Right arm under, left arm on top. Inhale, rise up, reach up. Place your foot, exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway. Left foot steps back. Crescent, inhale. Release your hands down. Front leg straightens. Maybe lift the foot except for the heel. And then plant your hands. Sweep the right leg back. Come high into the left toes. Bend your left knee. Look forward. Push from this left leg. Foot to your hands. Lengthen, inhale. And then bow in, standing splits. Good. Use your fingers. So that little hasta mudra, that little energy in your hands. Stay in standing splits. If you want, bend your left knee. Lift the heel. You can give yourself space. Don't have your hands right on top of your foot. And then if you want, it's that same energy. Bend the knee and push to lift. Bend the knee, push to lift. If you want to take this a step further, I inhale. Exhale, and then Uddiyana Bandha, that little lift to go up. Left foot comes back down. Spot the back of your mat. Stretch your right foot back. Skandasana. Cha-cha. Really nice. And then moving into side angle. So kind of dig that heel down. Come forward. Any version. Beautiful. What a funny feeling when you're pushed around. So you'll find your own transition. If you need to shorten up your stance to do this, you're going to plant your left hand, pick up your left foot, bring the knee into your tricep. Yes. Yes. And then right forearm comes around. Float your left leg back. Slide your left hand back more for chaturanga. Bring that left arm back forward. Place your foot. And Sphinx. Maybe float the elbows. Pull the hands back. And downward facing dog. Enjoy a breath or two. Left leg stretches back, inhale. Come high into your right toes. Bend the right knee. Just think, this is just down dog. I'm just going to the top of my mat. And bring that foot forward. Half moon, open up. Any version. And bring the knee around. Rise up. Cross, maybe wrap. Left arm under, right on top. Right Rise up, inhale, place your foot and hands to your heart, exhale. First and only chair pose of the day. Bend your knees, lower your hips, reach the arms up. And then sink down. Navasana. Really good. Right knee draws in. You can actually hold the knee, the shin. Extend the left leg. Slowly lower down. Good. And then reach the arms up to the sky. Left leg is just a little off the floor. Your knee, your right knee is into your chest as much as you can. Yeah. This was what we did in plank. This would be like when we were in plank and we drew the knee in. We were pulling the knee, the thigh into the chest. Good. Arms at your side. Stretch your right leg out to meet your left leg. Low boat. Rise up, Navasana.
We watch the stars come up. One by one.
Left knee comes in. You can hold the knee. Stretch that right leg away and then slowly control it back.
One by one.
Knee into the chest. Arms reach to the sky. This is your plank with your knee in your chest.
Blossom above.
Push the hands up. So spread the shoulder blades on your back.
Blossom above.
Arms reach forward. Leg reaches forward.
Good things come to those.
Release down. Beautiful. Bend your knees. Feet flat. Press down, lift up, bridge. Consider lifting your heels up, coming into your toes. Outer ankles gently inward. And shoulders firmly rooting down. Maybe lace the hands, but maybe not. One more inhale. Release down with your exhale. Breath in and breath out. Set up, bridge again, up bow if you want. Inhale, rise up. Maybe lift the heels again.
One by one, we watch the stars.
Last inhale. Release down.
We watch the star.
Breath in.
Blossom
up. And breath out. Set up one more back bend. Bridge or up bow. Any version.
Blossom up.
Maybe onto the toes again. And exhale, release out. Legs out straight on the ground. Hands to the sky. Contain your belly, contain your ribs. Start to squeeze the legs together as one. So maybe start with the big toes. The heels can be a little bit apart. Keeping the ribs, the belly intact as it is right now. Slowly taking those arms overhead. Noticing the effect that that has on your spine. So let me scoot over a little bit. As one of my teachers likes to say, if you're in a stiffer body, the odds of your spine moving here, well, this isn't exactly what he says. I'm kind of, based on what he teaches, and I completely agree, by the way. If you're in a stiffer body, I'm paraphrasing in the context. This is easier to keep your spine neutral than if you have a bendy spine, because when your arms go overhead, your back just wants to arch. With that said, if you have tight shoulders and a stiffer body, you're going to try to compensate to get the arms up by arching the back. Whatever kind of body you're in, we're not arching the back to get the arms overhead. I don't care how far overhead they go, but I do care. I don't want them resting on the floor. I don't want them resting, your hands or your arms resting on the floor. I want them off of the floor so that there's work here. Good. Now, draw the ribs back, the belly back. Stretch the toes long and then start to float the feet up. Arms are up, feet are up, your head is down. For now. Notice your glutes working. Maybe take the head up and then release it. Beautiful. Little pause here. Right knee into your chest. Give it a squeeze. Take the arms overhead again. Float your left leg up. Now it's going to be easier to get your shoulders and your head up off the ground if you want, because your knee is in. That's giving you a nice little counterbalance. So this is what we did just before with our arms to the sky, but with the arms overhead. So now this is taking it into a handstand shape. Both knees in, rest the head down. Both legs out long. Left knee comes in. Give it a squeeze. Float the right leg up, arms overhead, shoulders and head off the ground. Both knees in, rest down. Okay, so we're going to use that shape if you want to get upside down. You can do that with a headstand where you're drawing your knee into your chest. And you're using that shape to kind of center yourself and give yourself balance there. You can do it in handstand. You could even do it in pincha. I'm going to work it in handstand because we've been doing lots of prep for handstand. If everything I just said sounded really tedious to you, grab a block, put a block under your hips and take your legs up. Or do something else that like really speaks to you in this moment. And so here's what I'm talking about if you're working this in handstand. Give yourself some space, kind of pulling everything together that we've just built on. Give yourself some space, hands to foot. I like to center my foot to my hands. My leg is back. This bent knee is gonna drop more. So this is us moving from the back of the mat to the front of the mat. That's all it is. And then this is my swing leg. And I'm gonna use that same energy we used in down dog to lift and lower the leg to help guide myself up. And I'm going to pull my left knee into my chest. And I'm going to do that again until it starts to feel comfortable. Maybe like, I don't know, 5 times on one side and then like 5 times on the other side. Yep. Good. Gabriella, straighten out your top leg if you have the space. And yes, and then bend your bottom knee like crazy. And then pull your bottom knee into your chest when you go up. Yes, that's the energy right there. That was it. Yes, 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 yes. Beautiful. That's it, Jordan. Really good. You'll do each side. It's important that you do both sides. That last little bit I neglected to talk about, hands. Use those fingertips. Oh, there's so much, right? It's like, how do we pull all this stuff together? Use those fingertips. Use that little bit of Hasta Mudra there. And then when you've done 5 on both sides, that's it, Gloria. Beautiful. We'll make our way to sitting. Nice work. If you were in a headstand, you would need to take a child's pose. Other than that, you're pretty much good to come to sitting. Ah, very, very nice. Okay, sit comfortably. whatever that is, and then just a gentle twist. Lift the spine tall. You're not twisting from your hips. You're really not twisting from your belly or your low back. You're really twisting from your upper back. And as I say that, I don't want you to be rigid and too super glued into place with your lower spine and your hips. Give them freedom, but you're not trying to twist from your hips or your low back. Come back to center. Pause. Just feel that. Other side. Release to center. Just feel it. Palms turn up, just like we started. I gotta be honest with you, I'm a palm down girl. I really like my palms down. I feel like it centers me more. It's like I don't want anything outside. I wanna stay inside. But for today, I'm gonna see if I can go palms up here. I don't know what that says about me. I'm like insular and I like solitude. Allow your breath to soften. Feel all your foundation points, anything that's in contact with the ground or a block or whatever you might be sitting on. Sensation physically. You know, I like to say, take your temperature. How's your mood? How's your mind? How's your body? Any part of you, any aspect of you feels good, embrace it right now. If something feels maybe less than good and needs some attention, promise yourself that you'll take care of that piece. Bring your hands together in your heart. Lift your heart into your thumbs and just gently bow your mind to your heart. Honor yourself for showing up, for being here. Rise up, eyes open gently. Thank you for your practice. Happy Friday the 13th.